What if I told you you've been calculating your cycle wrongly? Most women think their cycle length is 28 because everybody says so. And when their period shows up early or later, they begin to panic. Now, the thing is, the average cycle length for women is 28. But that doesn't mean that every woman's cycle length has to be 28. So today, I'll show you how to calculate your menstrual cycle properly and when next to expect your period. I'm Nurse Sandra. I'm a registered nurse and midwife with a BNSC degree. On this channel, we'll talk about understanding your body, your health, and your fertility. This step I'm going to be teaching you is very simple. And once you get it, you finally understand how your body works and how to calculate your menstrual cycle. Now, what is a menstrual cycle length? Cycle length is not the number of days you bleed. Your menstrual cycle length is the number of days from the first day you see your period to the day before your next period begins. It's not the day you start seeing spotting or brown discharge. No. So let's say your period started on the 3rd of July. 3rd of July is going to be your day one. Your day one of your cycle. Now let's assume your period lasted for 5 days. This is day one, day two, day three, day four, day five. And it ends here. Then the next time you saw your period is 31st of July. Now, what you're going to do is, you're going to start counting from the first day you see your period to the day before your next period, which is this 30th of July. So we'll start counting from day one, day two, day three, day four, day five, day six, day seven, day eight, day nine, day 10, day 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. This 31st of July is day one of another cycle. So for this month of July, your cycle length is 28 days. Cycle length. So if your cycle falls between 21 to 35 days, it is considered normal. It's only when it's lesser than 21 or greater than 35 that it's considered abnormal. And that means you have to see your doctor. So now that you know how to calculate your menstrual cycle length, how do you now know how to predict your period? It's basically just the same thing. But let me just give another example. Now, if the 6th of July is day one of your cycle, and it lasted for 3 days, that's day one, day two, day three, and you have a 22-day cycle length. So when should you now expect your next period? That's simple. It's just basically the same calculation from the previous one we did. So you're going to start counting from day one, day two, day three, day four, day five, day six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. So that is 22. If your cycle length is 22, that means your next period is going to start on the 28th of July. This is going to be day one of another cycle. So that is basically how you calculate your menstrual cycle length. If your cycle is regular, this method will help you predict your period, understand your fertile window, and avoid surprises. Just track it consistently and your body and cycle will start to make sense. I have a detailed video on my channel where I talked about how to calculate your fertile window if you're trying to conceive and how to calculate your safe days to avoid pregnancy. Now, what if your cycle is irregular? Some women don't have the same cycle length every month. It may vary from 25, 28, 31, 35. You won't get results with this video. If you want a detailed video on how to calculate your cycle with irregular cycle, let me know in the comments below. If you're finding this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video to as many women you know, so a lot of women will get to see the video and learn from it. And always remember, your health is your wealth. Little changes makes a big difference. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.